Welcome to another video from Far North Bushcraft and Survival. We recently got word that our cabin had suffered some damage in a windstorm. So when we got here, this is what we found. This video is going to be about how we set about to try to repair the damage. Thursday, we tried to get into our cabin, and we couldn't make it. After getting stuck five or six times, we were wore out, and we gave up. We went back. Friday, we got a call from some folks that wanted to help us get into the cabin. So Saturday, we went into the cabin with some help. These are the folks just leaving on their way out. The tree fell onto our roof of the cabin and caused a bit of damage. So we're going to have to cut the tree off in sections to get it off the roof, because if we cut the whole top of the tree off, it might fall off of the cabin on one end and then the other end come fall back and hit the side of the cabin, causing more damage. So we got to cut it off in pieces. Now what I'm going to try to do is I'm going to tie a rope around the tree, throw it off the cabin, and then hook the snow machine up to the rope and try to pull it off of the cabin roof. I decided to use a bowline knot here because they're easy to untie even after they've been under tension. Things don't always go quite the way you plan them. This tree was being stubborn.
Okay, it's that tree is anchored a lot better than I thought it would be. Evidently the branches are down in that snow up there and they're frozen into the ice that's on top of the roof, and it's just not breaking loose. So I'm gonna have to take the rope loose here and make another circle around. I'm gonna have to get a little run at it and bust it loose, yank it loose.
Woohoo! We have a saying here in the United States, where there's a will, there's a way. And luckily, we found a way.
Well, we got it down. So now, what we're gonna have to do is shovel off that edge of that roof and just see if we can see what kind of damage is actually done on top. Now that the tree is down, we might be able to get a little bit better view from up there what the damage might be. I don't think there's hardly any damage other than to this 2x6, this shattered 2x6. So we did bring in a new one with us, although we have some stored under the cabin. We couldn't remember what we had stored under here, but as you can see, there are a couple. I'll have to measure them, see if they're long enough. If they are, we'll use those, one of those, instead of the bright new one. Because the bright new one would look more like these crossbars here. This crossbar and this crossbar. Bright. Well, it would look like the broken edges of that 2x6 that's up there. And that would be quite a contrast with the other that's up there. So we'll just use these weathered ones, one of these weathered ones, if they're long enough. That way it'll kind of blend in. Got it down. Now, just gonna hammer up these nails here and cut the new board. Cut the new board and get it in place, and then nail it. Now we'll have to get a saw. I'm not going to bother getting out a circular saw, skill saw. I'm just going to use a hand saw and cut that angle. Oh, it looks pretty good. We're using our Arctic Cat sawhorse. Works great. Alright, now let's go try to put this in place. Alright, here's where we're at on the cabin roof repairs. We've taken off the old one, the broken board, and we've taken all the nails out of the roof right in there that were long enough to stick down through the plywood, because that was preventing this 2x6 from going up where it belongs. Okay, you can see it's right up in the peak there where it belongs, but it's not high enough. And you can also see down here on the end, it's not high enough. The reason being is because that plywood was, the roof on top was bowed down because of the tree falling on it, laying on it for a week or two. So, we just got the 2x6 clamp there for right now. So what we got to do is we got to lift that 2x6 up, lift the whole thing up. So lift it up and then slide it up the roof to fit into the peak again. So this is what I come up with. I went out in the woods and I cut down a dead standing spruce. I shaved the sides on it a little bit right up near the top and nailed a couple of 2x6s on there as guides. Now we're going to try to sandwich this right over that 2x6 up there. Now, how do we jack it? Well, we jack it simply by sliding the butt on this 2x6. Yes, we are on a hill here, and this 2x6 is going down this way, but the roof is a much steeper pitch and it's going down even faster. So as we slide the butt down here, hopefully we are going to jack this 2x6 up. Let's see how it works out. Okay, we're ready to jack. Looks like it's already come up some. All right, here we go. That's looking pretty good. What we've got to do now is, if you notice up in the peak, we've got a gap now that we've lifted the board up. So we've got to move that board up the roof, up into where it nests tightly. So that's what I'm attempting to do here now. Got the height of this 2x6 where we want it now, relative to the other one, but we got to get tight against here. So I'm thinking one more whack will do it. We've had to go down to the bottom of our jack pole we're using as a jack, tap it out to drop this because it was too high. So now we've got the height right. Let's give it another tap and see if we can get this bottom tight right here. I like it. It looks good from down below here. Yes, the bottom is where it should be compared to this one, and the bottom is tight. So I'm going to go ahead and put a couple nails in it, and then we'll go to the other end and move the jack a bit. We may have to cut it shorter so that we can jack up that end. because as you can see, that end down there, at the end of the roof, not the end of the board, does not match up. So we're gonna have to jack it up. Right now, gotta get a nail into here. Got our first nail in. Now I wanted to point out, you probably already noticed, but I did put that light colored 2x6 in there as a backing. That was so that I could put the jack up there and this 2x6 would go against that board and this bottom would be held in place. But I had nothing to hold the top in place, when I put the jack up there. So I put that 2x6 up there as a backing, and that held this end in place. Really helped. Okay, I happen to think that these clamps would probably do a better job. So I'm gonna attempt to clamp this in place rather than to use the jack. Okay, that did it. There's still a little bit of difference here, but I think I can drive that up with a nail. So we'll see. Good enough. That's almost level. All right, mission accomplished. Now all we gotta do is go ahead and nail this up, go back up to the peak, nail that up, and then nail down the roofing. We're on the home stretch. Yahoo! Yesterday when we were working on the roof, we were struggling. I could not figure out how we could get that whole roof area up, that whole 2x6 up where it needed to go. And it was this slide jack that made the difference. That's what I'll call it, is a slide jack, because you slide the bottom of the jacket. And it did the job. So we're sure thankful for that. Well, there it is. The job is done. The roof is back to normal.
If you enjoyed this video, be sure and give it a thumbs up and to share it, as well as subscribe so you don't miss any more. And check out these suggested videos here. Thank you.